has a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute and just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. A town called Bel-Air. A town called Bel-Air. A town called Bel-Air. Said you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air. I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. This is what the people of Bel-Air.
What's good, y'all? And we back again with the last video of this series. Hold up, let me just adjust. So, if you guys watched the last few videos, we talked about San Diego State, UC Irvine, USF, and now the last college is USD. So the USD was probably the last college that we visited in Southern California, and that was the last college that I had in mind about transferring out from community college. So why not end it there? Let's get into it. As with the rankings and all that stuff, I had it ranked with like San Diego State number one, Irvine number two, and then USD at number three. So as you guys saw in the last video, Irvine bumped up to number one and San Diego State bumped down to number two. And that was probably the most surprising thing out of the whole thing. And San Diego USD was at the bottom. So I was like, I don't know what to expect here. I don't know anybody that goes here personally. It was kind of, it was interesting because I thought it was going to be like the USF for San Diego. Just nicer weather, you know, you're not as crowded with like the streets and like downtown San Francisco. I kind of knew that it was in like, it wasn't in the cuts, but it was more in like the upper part of San Diego with like the hills, you know? Like, so my first observations when we walked onto the campus was that it seems super modern in a way, and it felt like I was walking onto Princeton, like I was in Fresh Prince. You know, like I'm like the Will Smith, and then everyone else walking around there was probably like Carlton and all his homies, you know. And now I'm just that odd one out. It was just the vibe that I was feeling, you know. It wasn't something that I expected. As we were approaching the campus, there was a bunch of modern buildings. It looked very Catholic. Catholicist. That's a word. It felt like you were walking onto like a church campus, if that kind of makes sense, if you guys can relate to that. The buildings had like the church feel, the Roman Catholic feel, you know. So that was just one thing that I saw as walking onto the campus. And as you walk into the campus, keep in mind this was on Easter as well. We weren't expecting to see students, but there were parties going on. Like they rented out the hall, and people were having their Easter parties there. It looked like they had some activities going on like outside of the weekly school classes. You know, once we parked, we started to walk towards the buildings. They were very like, you can tell this is a very upper class school. Just by the way the buildings look. I'm not saying that like other campuses you can tell by like how the buildings look, but you can tell that this school is very, very funded with money. The buildings look very new. It looked like, at least it was, at, to my eyes, it looked like it was at least five, 10 year old buildings. Another thing that we saw was that there were places you can like chill. There were hammocks underneath the trees. There was these ginormous freaking beach chairs that you can sit in. Yeah, like you could just chill there. The quad area was very open. Again, being in SoCal, San Diego in particular, the weather's probably gonna be sunny about 80 to 90% of the time. So you won't really have to worry about the rain or it being cold, unless it's like in the winter time. But grass area was very open. You could probably put down a blanket and just study in the sun, you know. They had a church there just like USF. This one seemed a little bit smaller. USF's church was very big. I'm pretty sure that SeaWorld is close by to USD, and the beach is probably like over that mountain, like on the other side. There's an endless activities that you can do around the school area. Let's get into pros and cons. I saw a couple things that I wanted to let you guys in on, so let's get into it. The pros that I saw was definitely that the school is very new, and you can tell that they take good care of their stuff because the buildings didn't look like they were aging badly. Like, you didn't see any like moldings or anything on the walls or any, it didn't feel dirty at all. So you know that they keep the school clean. It's very well maintained. Another pro that I saw was that there's definitely a lot of parking. So if you're driving to school and you're not living on campus, then they definitely have a couple lots available for you to park in. I know when we were driving in, there was like this main street, and then there was a U-turn at like a cul-de-sac U-turn at the end. And they have parking spots along the side. But I'm pretty sure you have to probably get there like hella early just in order to get one of those spots. But they do have parking lots on either side. You won't have to worry about parking. Right when you drive in, there's a parking lot on the right side as well. So parking won't be an issue. I'm pretty sure it won't be an issue. Don't gotta worry about that. And again, I gotta bring it up. The weather, A1, fire, flames, sun, very low chance of rain. That's about it for the pros that I saw. I know there wasn't very many, but here are some of the cons that I saw. I'm not sure how good their sports teams are. When I'm watching like NCAA tournaments for like basketball or like doing some like fantasy football research and I'm looking for players to like pick up in the draft, I never see any players that come from USD. So I'm not sure how good their sports programs are. You guys can probably do your own research and kind of see if they're like D1, D2, D3, you know. Maybe they don't even have any sports teams, and maybe that might be a con for you. But for me, I'm a huge sports fan. Black and orange, you know, you always got to rep the Giants. Padres are my thing. San Diego doesn't have any basketball, so Warrior, Dub Nation, gang gang all day. And football, you know, the Chargers left you guys, but you know, that red and gold, baby, Niner faithful. Big sports fan, and that plays a huge part for me in picking a school, because if sports is really a big influence on my life, then it's like I kind of cut that out when I go to San Diego. So it's kind of sucks, you know, but it's all good. Some of you might not be huge sports fans and you might just want to be to go to school. Another con that I saw was that I didn't feel that I fit in there. When you walk onto a campus, you kind of be like, okay, like I can actually see myself interacting with some of the students here, some of the teachers, you know. But here it was kind of like I didn't fit in at all. There were parties going on, and I'm pretty sure the students were the one who had a party for their family. And when we were driving down, all you see is Mercedes, Porsche, BMW, Teslas, you know, like the nice fancy cars. And if you guys look back on my channel, I have some like Japanese cars. But this school looked like you have like, it's very upper class, like upper class. You can tell by the status that it has. When you drive up to the school, you're like, oh shoot, like is this Princeton, bro? Like, am I about to see Carlton? If I'm relating this to something, it's probably gonna be the Fresh Prince. And you guys, if you guys watch Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, you guys get the reference. Like, I'm gonna be Will with my inside out blazer, you know. I'm gonna approach a girl and I'm gonna be like, what's good?
But I think I've seen your picture somewhere before. Oh yeah, that's right. It was in the dictionary next to kablam!
You know, it's just one thing that I noticed. For sure, I'm not gonna fit in. I would definitely be a minority in the campus demographic. It's not for me, you know. Not every campus is gonna be for this part, for your particular circumstance. Those are some of the pros and cons that I saw. I originally had it San Diego State, Irvine, and then USD. Now it's Irvine, San Diego State, USD. So USD, it's staying the same. Those are just some of my final thoughts. I know this video is a little late. I recorded it last week, but the footage was choppy and it was just ugly. So I wanted to redo this video and get it out to you guys ASAP. Those are just some of my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think of USD. Maybe it's for you. Maybe I have a different perception of it. Maybe you go there and maybe you have a different perspective of it then. Let me know what you guys think. That's probably the end of this college review series, because that was the last college that I was thinking about. So I'll be coming out with a decision video soon. So stay tuned for that. Thank you guys for tuning in. Like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next week. Peace.